independent of everything and everyone.
Yeah, of course.
Right. We are on the same page. Because God has to be self-sufficient.
Yes.
Right?
Okay.
Okay. So do you believe in more than one self-sufficient being is possible?
Do I believe more than one self-sufficient being is possible? Yes, I do.
It's possible to have more than one independent being.
Then one more God. What do you mean? Like one more self-sufficient God or what? I don't think it's possible to have more than one God. I believe there's one God and that's it.
If God is self-sufficient, can there be another God who's also self-sufficient?
Can there be another God? Well, not as I know of, only the God that's here now.
Yeah. Does it even make sense that you can have two self-sufficient gods who are independent of each other?
So you're trying to say about the Holy Trinity, the Father, Son, Holy Spirit.
No, I am simply saying, when we have conception of God, we need to have the correct concept of God. Otherwise, you might yourself just fall short and worship this tripod.
Yes.
You know, helping that camera to stand. Because we didn't have the right concept.
Yes.
So God has to be someone who's a being that is self-sufficient. Doesn't need anyone else. It has to be independent and absolute.
Okay.
Do you agree with that?
I believe that God is just God, really. I believe in Jesus Christ as God. I believe in that's what I believe.
Any being to be God, do you agree at least the essential qualities of God, to be even called God, has to be someone who is self-sufficient, independent, all-powerful?
Yes, all-powerful, of course.
All-knowledgeable?
All-knowledgeable, yes.
Right.
Yes.
Okay. So, when you say there cannot be more than one of those beings, do you mean it?
That there can be not be more than one God. No.
There can be not more than one.
Even if I believe in another God, wouldn't I? If I believe in Allah or a Hindu or whatever, of course, I can believe there's only one God.
Okay.
That's what I can believe. Yeah.
So if this God has a daughter, would this daughter be self-sufficient?
Would this start? That's a good question. Would this start to be self-sufficient? I don't know.
Okay. What is a daughter to you? What does it mean, daughter or children?
What do you mean by that?
When you have a father and children, the father gives rise to, causes the children, right, to come into existence.
Yeah.
So, for the daughter to come into existence, they're dependent on the father.
Yes, and the mother. Yes,
right. So the daughter is not going to be self-sufficient. They will be dependent
on the father. Yes.
Right. So if God has children in any way, shape, or form that you can think of, they will be dependent on God.
Yes, of course.
Right.
Well, Adam and Eve were dependent on God, weren't they?
So do we at least agree that God would not have any children because those children would be dependent on him and he has no need for children?
So is that what we're trying to get at, Jesus?
I'm trying to get to a common understanding where we understand, without even resorting to our scriptures, what the correct concept of God is. Yeah?
Yes.
So if somebody says God has a, grandchild, then automatically think grandchild means he has a son or a daughter from which another generation came.
Yeah.
All of these will be
dependent
on God. So if
are
someone
dependent on God,
that's why I can never be God.
Exactly.
Right. So anyone who's dependent on God, they can never be God. Do you agree?
Of course. Yes.
So if God,
I'm trying to say Jesus, because is that what I'm trying to get?
Do you believe God has children, like a son or a daughter, who is self-sufficient?
I believe that God doesn't have. Well, I believe Jesus Christ was the Son of God. Yes.
Son is God's children, right?
Well, I believe in God became man of flesh. That's what we believe.
So Jesus is a son of God.
He said he's the Son of Man, isn't it? The Son of Man. That's he claimed to be. Son of God, yes.
When you say Son of God, do you mind explaining what you mean by this term?
He was God in flesh. That's what he believed. The Son of God, that's where his way he interpreted us.
So you have God the Father, and you have
God the Son and God the Holy Spirit.
So the God the Son that you're now bringing into this equation, is he self-sufficient?
God the Son, was he self-sufficient? Yes. Well, all his miracles was through God, wasn't it? That's what he says. When the Jews were condemning him, he said, I cannot do this without my Father.
Is he dependent on the Father for his existence?
Was he dependent on? Yes.
Then he is not self-sufficient.
Well, that's what you're trying to say about God being the Creator, that he doesn't depend on no one. That's what you're trying to say.
So if you have a Son of God, if you call him Jesus,
yes,
or anyone else by this name, some people call him, you know, Ganesh,
your Shia.
So these sons or daughters of God, they're not self-sufficient. They are dependent on God. By that definition, they are not God, because only God is self-sufficient. Anyone else who is dependent on God, they are not God.
So you see, that's why that's your argument coming and say Jesus.
But do you agree? Do you agree? They cannot be God. Not that I'm just stating. I'm saying you have to affirm that they cannot be God.
No, I can't, because at the end of the day, if you look at it, okay, you look at the argument, in fact, we're probably going to change the subject, okay? People say, how could Jesus be God, or all that, right? But if you look at it, when he was on the cross, he says, Father, Father, forgive them. Now, I know Muslims' argument to say that, who was he talking to? If he was on the cross, where was he talking to? But other people say, can God be anywhere? Can God be, what do you believe? Do you believe in God can be anywhere? Do you?
I don't believe God is everywhere.
You don't believe in God is anywhere. You don't believe God is everywhere. No.
What do you understand?
You not believe in God can be in India, God can be in America, God can be in Spain.
Let me explain to you. Let me explain to you what I mean.
I can't understand.
Is this universe part of everywhere?
This world or this?
This world.
Yes.
Right.
So you're saying that God can't be everywhere?
Just one moment.
Okay.
Just one moment to understand what we're talking about.
So at what point do you want to be?
Did this world always exist?
This world, it didn't exist, no.
Okay. So when
it
always
didn't exist, so.
So where was the world when it didn't exist?
Well, in the Bible it says, in the beginning, the world was with him.
No, the world. The world.
Where was the world before it existed? The world wasn't there before it existed.
Right. So when the world didn't exist, was God in the world?
Well, of course he wasn't in the world if it didn't exist.
So God wasn't everywhere.
God was the beginning, wasn't he? He was the beginning.
When you say God is everywhere,
was he the beginning?
So when he created the world, are you saying he became part of this world? When he created this world, what happened? He now changed from where he was and became part of this world? He became into this world, everywhere, every single atom of this world? Is this what you're saying? He wasn't everywhere in this world before, right?
He wasn't ever in this world before.
Because the world wasn't there.
He wasn't there, of course.
So after the world was created, he then became part of this world. So he changed from not being everywhere to being part of this world. So he wasn't everywhere before.
Well, he was in the beginning. Of course he was. God is... So but do you not, do not believe God is everywhere right now? Do you know between me and you we're having a conversation? You don't think God knows this?
So you believe God is in hellfire too? Every single atom...
He's not in hellfire. No, he's not in hellfire.
Is hellfire part of everywhere?
Hellfire isn't a part of everywhere, no.
Okay, so we have a different understanding of what everywhere means then. Because to you, hellfire is not part of everywhere. I thought everywhere means everywhere, not a single place that's missing. Okay, so this is a different understanding of everywhere. So let's move back to the topic we were discussing. If God has a son, he cannot be self-sufficient, as we agreed. He will be dependent on the Father.
No.
So, the son...
Yeah.
Did he exist by himself?
He existed through God, of course.
Let's start with Jesus. Let's start with Jesus Christ, right?
Yeah.
Did he exist without a beginning?
No, of course not.
Did he exist?
Well, actually, stating that, go back to the Bible. John says, in the beginning, the world was with him, through him, the world was made. Even though the world was made by him, the world did not recognize him. So actually, the Bible is stating that he was the beginning. So that's what.
Was he before the beginning?
No, he says he was the beginning.
I'm asking you a different
question.
I'm asking
a
different
question.
You see, the world
says,
the world.
Glorify me with the glory I had with you before the world was.
The world that we are talking about, my friend. The world we're talking about didn't always exist. It had a beginning. John talks about the beginning of this world. I am saying, before the beginning of this world, did the Son exist by his own self, independently of anyone, being dependent on anyone?
So you're saying in the beginning that Jesus didn't exist by himself?
I'm simply asking you to explain.
Yeah.
Before the world was in existence...
God was the beginning.
Before the world was in existence...
Yeah.
Did the Son exist by himself without the need of the Father?
I told you what the Bible says. In the beginning, the Word was with him. and all things were made through him. That's what it says in the Bible. So he's saying he was the beginning. That's what I'm saying. He's saying Jesus claiming to be God. That's what he's saying in the book of John.
So let's come back.
Sure.
I'm not speaking to you. I'm sorry.
No, respectfully.
Do you associate yourself with...
No.
One second. Do you associate yourself with people who insult my prophet?
No, I do not.
I'm not insulting.
So the people who are just there with a pose...
I'm not the insulting type.
I'm asking a simple question. Do you associate yourself with people who carry your Quran drilled holes in it? Do you associate yourself with them?
Because if you do,
then you can have another discussion elsewhere. I'm not interested.
I don't enjoy conversation with people
who insults my prophet. If someone insults my mom and dad, I won't be happy. My prophet, we love our prophet more than our mom and dad. And you think that we will just tolerate it like that? We will say, sorry, we're not interested with you.
But
right?
Why are you pointing this towards me? I never had... Well,
speaking to this friend of yours. Now...
I don't know.
Speaker's corner.
By the way, Sam, nice to meet you.
What's your name? What's your name?
Sean, nice to meet you.
Sean. I'm Mansoor.
I've seen you on...
So when we talk about God...
Yeah.
The Son, you say, he existed independently.
In the beginning, the Word. See, he was saying he was the beginning.
I'm asking you to affirm with me. And so you affirm.
And I believe that God created.
You see, look, I'm trying to understand what you really believe.
Yeah.
Do you believe the Son always existed?
I believe God always existed, yeah. That's why I'm trying to say Jesus was God.
So he
didn't feel his name.
So Jesus, who is God, always existed.
Yes.
Right. Was he ever dependent on the Father for his existence?
Was he dependent? Well, he was born through Mary. He was God himself. He was conceived through a miracle, wasn't he?
My question is something different. Was he ever dependent for his own existence on the Father?
He was God.
So the answer is what?
He was God. Jesus was God. Am I right here?
So are you saying he's not going to talk to me? So are you saying he was dependent or he was not dependent?
I'm saying he was God.
No,
I'm saying it, whatever about dependent and saying he was God.
My question is not about whether he's God or not.
Yeah.
Do you follow my question?
Oh, you're saying was he dependent on the Father? That's what you're trying to say.
Yes.
He was the Son of God.
Was he?
I'm saying that he was God.
But that's not my question, though.
He was the Son of Man. He was God.
I'll ask you two questions.
Yeah.
Was he God?
Yes, he was God.
Second question.
He was God in flesh. That's what we believe. He died for our sins. He died on the cross.
Sean, did you say your name is?
Sean, yes.
Sean, thank you for answering my first question. My second question. Being God, was he dependent on the Father for his own existence?
He was dependent on himself. He was God.
So, was he... the answers are... going to make it easy for you, Sean.
Can I make it easy for you?
Yeah,
yeah.
When I ask you, was he dependent, the answers are, yes, he's dependent. No, he's not dependent. Or I don't know. Maybe. I don't care. So I'm giving you five options. Yes, no, maybe, I don't care. And what's the other one?
I understand that Jesus
was
He was God.
So which one is it?
He was God. He was the best known. He was God.
So Sean, yes or no, maybe, I don't know, I don't care. Which one?
I don't care.
Right. So you don't care. So
I'm just saying that what the Bible says, in the beginning the Word was with him and all things was made through him. So he's claiming, he said he was God.
So is the Father...
Do you not believe God would come man? You don't believe that God could come man? Do you not believe that? No.
When he said...
believe that God can become a man.
Let's understand one thing.
Could do into your life.
We are talking about the existence of more than one God. The Father, you believe is God. And yet we have another one called the Son is also God.
The Holy Three in one, the Father, Son, Holy Spirit. That, you know, that's what Christians believe. Yeah. You believe in one God, Allah. We believe in, you know, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. We believe in Jesus was God.
Is the Son sovereign God?
What do you mean, Son, sovereign God?
Is he sovereign?
I don't know what you mean by sovereign.
Sovereign means, does he do things by his own self? That he can do, he doesn't have to listen to anyone.
Like the kings and queens
are supposed to be sovereign on earth when they rule their country. Yeah. They can get advice, whatever, but they don't have to. They can just say, off with your head. The Queen of England says, off with your head, and that's it. That's the law. That's what we mean by sovereignty. So when I'm asking you about the son. Is he sovereign?
That Jesus couldn't go around saying
that. No, I'm asking you a simple question. Was he a sovereign God?
Was he a sovereign God?
Can he do things of his own self?
He could have. Listen, okay. Could I state something, right? Jesus could be born into any family he wanted.
That's not my question.
He was born into an obscure character.
I'm not talking about human beings and umbrellas. Let me explain in a way that you understand. Imagine Jesus.